Today we're talking about medication reconstitution. When you're working with medications that come in a vial as either a liquid or a powder, we sometimes need to dilute this in order to administer it safely. So we're going to look at that right after this. Welcome back. My name is Tammy and this is NurseMinder, and on this channel we do everything nursing. So if you're new here, consider subscribing below so that you get the next video when it's released. Let's begin with an example of ondansetron 0.15 milligrams per kilogram IV 1 hour prior to chemo, and our patient weighs 65 kilograms. We need to begin with our parenteral monograph. Looking at the guidelines here, I do see that 1.5 milligrams per kilo is a good dose, it's a safe dose. So we're going to go back now and calculate how many milligrams of this medication will I need to draw up. Quickly doing our math, 0.15 milligrams per kilogram is my order, and I have a patient who's 65 kilograms. I now know that I have to draw up 9.75 milligrams of medication. Going back to the monograph, I see that there's a max dose of 16 milligrams, of which this is a safe dose. Looking at the medication and how it's available, I see that it comes in a 20 ml multi-dose vial at 2 milligrams per ml. So I need to continue on with my math now and determine how many mils do I need to draw up. I know that it is available as 1 ml equals 2 milligrams, and I need 9.75 milligrams for a dose. Again, dimensional analysis, cross off your milligrams, and we're going to do this calculation. And I quickly learned that what I need is 4.875 mils. Now don't forget your rounding rules. Rounding rules mean if it's greater than 0.5, we round up, so we're going to need 4.9 mils. So we're not quite done our math yet. I see I need to dilute this dose into 50 to 100 mils of dilutant, but I need a max concentration of 1 milligram per mil. So I need to make sure that if I pick a 50 mil bag or a 100 mil bag, I have the correct concentration. So we'll do the math here for a 50 mil bag first. I want to know milligrams per mil. Completing this calculation, I see that I actually have a 0.195 milligrams per mil, which is well within my safe dose. Say you didn't have a 50 mil bag available, you only had a 100 mil. Quickly calculate that dosage out as well to make sure you're within the safe range, and you find that you have 0.097 milligrams per mil. So now we're ready to select our tools to draw up our medication. Looking at the supplies I have here, I see that I have both a blunt fill needle and a blunt fill needle with a filter. Now the filter is the one with the purple cap here, and why we use a filter is we don't want to get shards of glass into our patient's medication, so we often use the filter when we're working with ampules. Now because I'm working with a vial, it's got a rubber stopper, I don't need to have the filter on there, I'm just going to use the blunt end. So I've selected my needle, now I need to select my syringe. I have a 3 mil and a 10 mil syringe available to me. Ideally a 5 mil would be better, but I don't have one in my facility today and I need to give my medication, so we're going to take a look at both of these. First let's look at the 10 mil. When I look at the breakdown of units here, I can see I've got 1 mil, 2 mil, 3 mil, and then I've got these black lines in between. Now each one of those black lines represents 0.2 of a mil. So if I needed 4.9, I could accurately get 4.2, 4.4, 4.6, 4.8, and 4.9 comes somewhere between this black line and the 5 mil. So it's going to be hard to get an accurate dose with this 10 mil, so I'm not going to choose to use this one. Now I know with a 3 mil, I'm looking to draw up 4.9 mils, so I'm going to have to use two of these to get the dose that I need. So just to look at the syringe first, when I'm looking at the 3 mil syringe, I can see that I've got my 1 mil, I have a half a mil, which means that each line in between is a tenth of a mil. So this would be from 1 half to 0.6, 0.7, 0.8, 0.9, 1 mil. So if I draw up 3, for example, in this syringe, I would need to still drop 1.9 in my other syringe, and I can accurately get to 1.9 with this equipment, so I'm going to choose 2 3 mils. Okay, so don't forget to do your 30 second scrub on the top. We'll check that medication one more time on Dantrolene, 2 milligrams per mil. I want 4.9 mils.
I've got my air in my syringe. And I'm going to draw up a full 3 in this vial. Again, it's okay to go past it. I always like to make sure I get my air out. And I'm exactly at the 3 mil. There. I'm going to recap this one and label it. Now I've just got that one non-filter, so I'm just going to snap on here the second filter. Clean again in between. Drop my air. And I want to pull up to 1.9 now. So I always like to go past, get rid of the air bubbles.
Now to administer this medication, we need to add this medication into a solution that is stable, and you find this information off your parenteral manual. So for this one, I have a 50 ml bag of normal saline, and I checked the expiry date and it says December of 2018. Now I'm using the 50 ml bag because that's the calculation I decided to go with. We're going to access this through the rubber stopper. We're going to cleanse it with our alcohol swab, and we're going to insert the needle of our blunt fill into that rubber stopper. So you can see the needle here is inside, and we're going to insert the medication. We'll complete this with our second vial of medications for that total dose of 4.9 mils or 9.75 milligrams. And then we'll be ready to administer this to our patient. Again, go to your parenteral manual for further instruction on how to administer.
So that was an example in using a medication that's already in a fluid state. So next we're going to look at medication that comes as a powder, because we need to dilute this medication and then decide how much of the diluted medication we're drawing up to administer. So let's look at another example.
So let's start with this order of 600 milligrams of an antibiotic. When I look at the vial, I see that there are several different strengths in which I can dilute my medication. So I do have a desired dose of 600 milligrams, and I have several options for an available dose. Let's take a look at our vial again. If I want a concentration of 300 milligrams per mil, I need to add 9.6 mils of dilutant, and I will have a total volume of 10 mils. At a concentration of 300 milligrams per mil, I still don't have my desired dose. So I need to figure out how many mils I would use if I were to reconstitute with 9.6 mils. So using dimensional analysis, I will solve for this equation, and I can see that I would need 2 mils of the medication at this concentration. Now I also have the option of doing a 400 milligrams per mil concentration or a 500 milligram per mil concentration. So let's look at those two next. So with 400 milligram per mil concentration, it indicated I would need 7.1 mils of dilutant for a total volume of 7.5 mils. You'll notice as the total volume decreases, the concentration increases. Using dimensional analysis at this concentration, I would only need 1.5 mils of medication. Similarly, for the 500 milligram per mil concentration, the recipe required 5.6 mils of dilutant. I would have a total volume of 6 mils. Using dimensional analysis again, I discover I would only need 1.2 mils of the medication to achieve the desired dose.
So after looking at my equipment, I have a 3 mil syringe. I've decided to use the 300 milligrams per mil concentration because I can accurately draw up 2 mils. So going to my vial, I now know I need 9.6 mils of a dilutant. So I have my dilutant. You still need to clean the top before accessing. I've grabbed a 10cc syringe, put my air in, and now I'm going to drop 9.6 mils of saline. Be sure to get rid of your air. Again, you want to clean this. And now I'm going to insert. So this is the powder. And as I insert, it will start to diffuse and mix. I'm getting a lot of resistance now, so I'm going to pull my needle out of the fluid and let the air come out. I just let go of the depressor and it naturally. And make sure I insert the rest of that fluid. Now it's important that when you're mixing this, you just roll it in your hands gently. And then we inspect to see if it's all mixed. Once you inspect that there is no more particle, we can go ahead and draw up the required dose. So remember, I now have 300 milligrams per mil, and there's 10 mils in this vial. We're going to clean again. And now I'm going to drop my 2 mils. Get rid of those air bubbles. We're ready to go.
Well, there you have it. Now you are able to reconstitute your drugs using the information in your facility so that you can administer your medication to your patient safely. Until next time, make it a great day.